Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I'm the host and the visionary of the Valder Beebe Show's God Talk. Some people talk to God and others believe that God talks to them. Join us in conversation with authors, religious clergy, metaphysicians, and regular people like you and I and God Talk. God Talk is a podcast available on FM radio, Roku TV, and online. Subscribe at ValderBeebeShow.com. You can also subscribe at youtube.com/ValderBeebeShow. Join the conversation of God Talk. I'll see you there.
Good morning, Dr. Charles Geyer. Welcome to the Valder Beebe Show today. How are you?
I'm doing well. Thanks for inviting me to be part of your show.
Well, I'm so excited because you get to tell us about new research from a prominent cancer meeting for people with early breast cancer. And I want people to listen and listen closely because breast cancer is still a major factor in our lives. Dr. Geyer, what happened at that meeting that can benefit us to know?
Well, at the meeting, we had opportunity to present the culmination of about an 8-year global effort to study a drug that targets a vulnerability in cancers that develop in women and men who inherit a abnormal BRCA gene from mom or dad. Okay, so this is that subset of patients, and about 100,000 patients a year will develop breast cancer because they inherited that abnormal gene from mom or dad. And the important thing about those cancers is they tend to come on at an earlier age. So these patients tend to be younger, you know, with less other illnesses, basically very healthy people. So it's very impactful. The disease also tends to be more aggressive, higher grade in that group of patients. Now we treat those cancers in those patients just like we treat more aggressive cancers that develop in patients who do not have those mutations. And the therapies have been effective. We now are curing the majority of patients, whether they have the BRCA mutation or not. But with these higher risk cancers, larger cancers, higher grade cancers, even with all our best therapy, our standard therapies, there's still about a 25 to 35% chance of recurrence. And so we're always looking for things that we can do to chop that down and have more and more patients cured of disease. And it's interesting because the BRCA gene mutation that causes the cancer to develop makes those cancers vulnerable to inhibiting another gene product protein called PARP. Both of the BRCA, the PARP, are part of maintaining our DNA integrity. And if you mess with that too much, cells die. So PARP inhibitors do have a good effect from our perspective on BRCA associated cancers. Those drugs have been approved for use in metastatic cancer. We wanted to see, can we use these drugs to cure more women with early breast cancer? And the results basically said, yes, we can.
So this BRCA, which we've heard a lot of called BRCA, is mm-hmm. this cancer confined to women or is it that small amount of men who also get breast cancer? Does that impact them?
Good question. Yes. No, men can develop breast cancer, but it is pretty unusual in men. The exception to that is that men who have the BRCA gene are at a little bit elevated risk for developing breast cancer as well. And we did have a small number of men participate in our trial. So this is a disease that certainly can affect both sexes.
Genetic testing, what do we need to know about that?
Well, genetic testing is become increasingly important for us in the management of our patients diagnosed with breast cancer. And there's not every patient needs it. It's kind of a complex area that we don't have time to get into here, but it is one of those things that we look at. We take a family history, we study the features of cancer, different things, and there's criteria that tell us we should look for a BRCA gene if the patient is unaware. Now, sometimes patients know they have the mutation and the cancer develops, We've got it, but frequently, and the patients coming into our study basically learned they had the BRCA mutation when their cancer was discovered. So this is something that is more and more assessed, and we're doing testing in an increasing number of patients who come to us with newly diagnosed breast cancer.
I want my audience to know that Dr. Charles Geyer, he's the professor of medicine of the Weill Cornell Medical College and the Houston Methodist Academic Institute. Dr. Geyer, finally, what do you want my audience to be left with, and where can they get more information?
Well, the best source of information about anything related to cancer, early detection, screening, BRCA, whatever somebody's interested in, I think is with the National Cancer Institute's website. They have a very a broad array of highly authoritative things that are tailored for lay people to explore. I really encourage people, though, to also talk with their physicians if they have questions, about cancer screening. We clearly want to encourage women to get their annual screening mammography, know your family history. If the doctor asks you your family history, really try and get information, because that's a major part of what we use to determine who needs testing, who doesn't. Sometimes you don't know your family history. People are adopted. People don't know dad's side of the family, these sorts of things. But get as much information as you can. The more information, the more specific information, the more your healthcare provider can guide you to the best approach that you can use to maintain your health.
Dr. Geyer, thank you so very much for speaking on this topic and bringing it to the attention of those of us who need to know and those of us who want to know. And thanks for being my guest on the Valder Beebe Show.
My pleasure. You have a good day.
I'm Valder Beebe. I host the Valder Beebe Show, broadcast on radio and television. And this is my phone pouch. My phone pouch is a great invention. It allows me to go hands-free, pocket-free, purse-free, even belt-free. Head on over to myphonepouch.com.